everybody, welcome to another episode of Shop My Stash, and like always, this is the new makeup that I have never tried before. The stuff on the side is what I picked to bring into my stash this week. So first off, for eyeshadow palettes, I'm going to bring in this Morphe Bronzed Mocha palette. This is the 25B. I'm going to bring in both of these blushes. This one right here is the Milani Luminoso blush that everybody used to rave about, and I still have never tried. And then this blush here, this is the Laura Geller Baked Gelato Vivid Swirl blush in Papaya. And then bring in this Revlon Color Stay in the color teal. And then just a Wet n Wild black eyeliner. This is the Megalast, and the color is called Blackest Black. All right, and then I only bring in three lip products because I have four in one of my project pans. So I have two Lorac ones. This one is in Cat Lady, and this other one is in Optimist. Then I'm going to bring in this NYX Simply Red Lip Crayon, and this is in the color Candy Apple. All right, so those are the swatches right there. The first one is Cat Lady. The second one is Optimist. Both of those are by Lorac, and then this bottom one here is NYX Candy Apple. All right, so that is it for new makeup that I'm bringing into my stash. So let's get on to my stash and pick out some things. Okay, so this drawer right here has all my foundations in it, and I really want to use this one up. This is a Korean brand. It's called April Skin, and it's a cushion foundation, and I really need to use it up. I think it's almost gone. So I'm going to bring just this one in to make myself use it up before it dries out. I also have another foundation and a BB cream in my Finish 18 by 2018. So if this one is used up, then I can just go on to those. All right, so this drawer right here has concealers, CC creams, BB creams, and color correctors back there. I am currently working on a concealer. I've done cut the top part of it off, so it's going to dry out if I don't use it up. And I also have one in my project pan as well. So I'm not going to bring any of those in. And then I also am working on a BB cream and a CC cream to finish them up as well. So I'm not going to bring in anything from this drawer. All right, so this drawer right here has all of my setting sprays. And then these are all of my primers. The ones that I brought in for primers last week, I'm still haven't used the Smashbox one, and the Lancome is still going strong, which it needs to get out of my stash. It's almost gone. Not that I hate it, it's just almost gone, so I need to hurry up and use it up. So I'm not gonna bring in any of my primers because I wanna work on what I have. And then for setting sprays, I know my Wet n Wild is almost gone that I have in my stash, so this one I need to change out. I'll bring in this one. This is actually Project Beauty's Spray Set Go, but I didn't like the sprayer on it, so I just repotted it after this one was gone. And then I think I might bring back in this Sephora one because I really did enjoy this one. All right, so this drawer right here has liquid eyeliners back there and mascaras all here. There are tons of them. I'm needing to pull some in because one of them was dried out, one of them is gone. I think two of them are gone actually that I've used for this past week. So I've been doing pretty good on mascara, so I need to pull something else in from this drawer. So I think I might bring this e.l.f. Mineral Infused Mascara. I've actually heard really good reviews on this. I haven't tried it, but my other e.l.f. one, it actually dried out before I actually got to try it. So I'm gonna bring this one in, and then I need to start using some of these samples as well. So I'm going to bring in this MAC False Lash Extreme Black, and then this Tartist Mascara. So that'll be all from this drawer because I don't need a liquid eyeliner right now. All right, so this drawer is not very full, but this is all my single eyeshadows. They're cream, liquid, or single. This one right here has two in it. But I'm bringing in the Morphe palette to do the 1 week one palette, so I'm not going to choose anything from this drawer. All right, so these two top drawers have eyeshadow palettes in them, and I'm not bringing any of those in, so we're just gonna skip those for now. All right, so this drawer right here has all of my bronzers and face palettes and powders in it. All right, so I think I'm gonna bring in this. This is by IBY. This is the highlight and contour palette, and that is what it looks like right there. All right, and so next I'm gonna bring in this Bare Minerals Invisible Light palette. This actually has a matte side and a glow side, and I really enjoy this. All right, so this next drawer right here has all of my highlighters in it, and I'm gonna bring in this cargo highlighter. All right, and that is the color there. They call it bronze. And it's a really pretty highlight. All right, and then I'm gonna bring in this Becca Prosecco Pop highlighter. It's a really pretty highlighter. I enjoy it. And that's a swatch of it there. This one is a little bit lighter than that one, but they're almost pretty much the same color. Maybe they don't. When I look at them up close, they don't really look as similar as they do on my hand. All right, and this drawer right here has all of my blushes in it, but I did bring in two blushes, so I'm not gonna bring in anything from this drawer. All right, so this right here holds my fake eyelashes, my eyeliners, which I'm not gonna bring in any eyeliners because I brought some in. My lip liners, my lip glosses, which I'm not bringing lip glosses in either because I have one in my Finish 18 by 2018 that I really want to work on. Chapsticks and brow products, which I'm not bringing in any of those either because I don't have them in a project, but I have three of them that I want to finish and they're almost gone. So let's select lip liners. All right, so these are the three lip liners that I decided to choose after looking at the colors of the lipsticks that I brought in. So I brought in this L'Oreal Color Rich in Always Red, this Maybelline Color Sensational in Magnetic Mauve, and then this Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Lip Pencil in Pay. This is where I keep all my lipsticks. These are all lipsticks here. These are all liquid lipsticks over there. I'm not going to pick anything from here, but I wanted to show you guys where I keep them. And excuse the mess up here. That's most of just stuff that I've chosen for Shop My Stash. All right, so now we're in my makeup drawer for the past week. I still haven't used this LA Girl white foundation. This Smashbox I never end up using because I'm trying to finish up this Lancome, which I cut off the top to it, so it's really close to being gone. And then I also have this Makeup Forever Step 1 primer that I just used on my cheeks, and I cut the top off that, and that is almost gone as well. So then for backup, I have the Benefit the Professionals primer that I'm going to use, and then this Smashbox illuminating primer. I haven't used that either because I've really been trying to get this one gone, but I guess I had more product in it than I thought. So for concealers, I do still have this Revlon Age Defying. I had to cut the top off that one as well. It is almost gone. And then I do have one in my project that I'm going to use after this one is gone. And then this right here, this is the Maybelline Dream Lumi. Supposed to be a concealer that's supposed to like luminize. It really doesn't luminize anything, and it's too dark for my skin. So what I do is I use it underneath my foundation, and I'm just going to use this until it is gone. So it's going to stay in here. And basically the same thing with this one, this e.l.f. concealer and then illuminator on the other side. I really don't like this, so I just use it on my nose, chin, and forehead to try to use it up. And then this illuminator I'm not really using as of this moment. Max Fix Plus, this is just gonna stay in there. This Wet n Wild setting spray, I think I have like one more use in it, so I'm gonna keep it in and use the rest of it. And then this Cover FX illuminating setting spray, this one is decent. I wouldn't say favorite, but I do enjoy it. The mist on it is super, super light. It's almost like I can't even explain the way it sprays, but it's like a super light spray. All right, this right here is just my color corrector. I haven't actually used that this week either. I barely ever use color correctors, so that's just gonna stay in there until I show it some love. This is what I brought in, this NYX lip cream in XOXO. This is a really pretty color. This Koki Kissable liquid lipstick in Mad About You, I did enjoy that. And then this Lorac in Damsel, this was a really, really pretty color. And then these were the three lip liners that I brought into my stash this week. I liked all of them. It was the Maybelline Color Sensational, both of these are, and then this is Lorac, which I really enjoy that formula as well. All right, these are the three brow products that I'm trying to use up. This one, I love this one. This is probably a favorite for me, but it is almost gone, so I just want to use it till it's gone. And then these two are decent. I think the Winky Luxe is probably my least favorite, and it is drying out really quickly. So if I'm going to try to work on it more this week, and I'm probably going to have to declutter it soon because I feel like it's drying out a lot. And then this Cello one, if you guys can see, I mean, I have like barely none left. So almost finished, and then I can start focusing on other brow products. All right, this Stila liner, liquid liner. I don't use liquid liners a lot. I have tons of them. I really need to try to focus on using them because I suck at using them. I probably need to put one of these in a project just to try to use some of them up. But I haven't used it still, so that's staying in there. And then Marc Jacobs highliner, and this is in Earthquake. I really enjoy it. And then this Revlon Photo Ready Matte Charcoal. That's what the color is. I did like it. It wasn't my favorite, but I did enjoy it. I'm not sure if I'm a big fan of gray liners. All right, and this is a sample of Urban Decay Primer Potion that I've been working on. I'm still on the first sample, so that stuff's gonna take me forever to finish. All right, so on to this part of the drawer, this Physicians Formula Blush. I don't even know what it's called anymore. Nude Wear, I guess that's what it's called. And after these letters wear off, I'm not going to know what it is, but this was a decent blush. This Truffle Cosmetics, I only actually used this one time, and I swirled my brush in all three of the colors, which I liked. And then this Pacifica blush, and the color is Wild Rose. I enjoy that color as well. All right, so on to powders. This right here, I did not like it at all. This gave me cake face. This is the Physicians Formula Mineral Wear Talc-Free Mineral Oso Radiant Powder. I am getting rid of this because I don't like it. Powders and me don't really get along too well, and I've been finding a little bit more powders that I do enjoy, but that one did not work for me. This Wet n Wild Contour Palette, I did actually start to enjoy this palette. So I'm going to keep it, but I'm going to rotate it out for this week. And then this bronzer from Physicians Formula. The only thing I don't like is these two right here are shimmery shades. And then these two are matte. So I try to focus my brush over here. I don't know what I'm going to do with this over here. So I'm going to put it back for now, but I'll figure it out. And then this Ofra highlighter in Rodeo Drive is one of my favorite highlighters in the world. It is so, so, so beautiful. And that is a swatch of it right there. It is so gorgeous. And then this Luna highlighter in Calypso. And that is a swatch of that highlighter. I really enjoyed both of them. All right, so now on to mascaras. This is where I keep all my mascaras in here. This one I just opened. This is by Butter London. It's the Iconoclast. I'm not a big fan of this. This I definitely would not recommend. I've only used it twice, but I'm not really a big fan. And the wand is just kind of funky. Not my favorite. This Clinique, I think it's finally dried up and now it feels like it has some in it. All right, so I'm gonna keep this in because I thought last time I used it, it was dried, but I did use all of this primer. It was all right. I wouldn't like tell you to go buy it. Now this primer right here, this Laura Geller Fortifying Lashes. This stuff is amazing. Oh my goodness. This is probably my new favorite product. I have been enjoying it. I actually put this on my lashes and forgot that I didn't put on mascara and wore this just this all day long. That's how good it is. It is gorgeous and it's black, and the wand is just a normal, really chunky mascara wand. I really enjoy this and I definitely would repurchase. This right here is the Lancome Hypnose Drama. I did enjoy this. The wand is the one that's kind of like a bendy wand, but it did get kind of thick on me, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw this out, but I did enjoy it. Would I repurchase? I don't know, but I would like to use it again. All right, and then the next one is this e.l.f. I don't really know what kind of mascara this was. I remember I used it once and then I never used it again and forgot about it, so I figured I would pull it in, and when I went to go use it, it's like completely dried out. Like it's even dried on the wand. It's unusable. All right, and then last is this CoverGirl, the Supersizer Mascara. This is what I use on my bottom lashes. It's a really small wand. It's my favorite bottom lash mascara. All right, so that is it of what I had in my drawer for last week. I'm gonna go ahead and put everything back and I'll be right back. All right, so this is my drawer for the next week. I did forget to talk about my foundation that I had in my project last week. This is the Wet n Wild Foundation Photo Focus Foundation. collection, and this is in nude ivory. I tried to do like a color match online where you choose different foundations and what color you are, and this showed this color, but I feel like this color is just a little bit too light for me. I did enjoy it though. This is a decent foundation. I like the price, and I definitely would recommend, and I would repurchase. The only thing I don't like about this is this applicator. OMG. It's like a hard plastic. I don't even know if I can get all the foundation off, but this is like a hard plastic spatula, and I don't like that. All right, so I hope you guys enjoy this episode of Shop My Stash. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.